The Rangers and the Islanders played a penalty-filled affair again. And in stark contrast to what we saw on Thursday night, it was the penalty killers that made the impact, and the Islanders wasted six different power plays, including a lengthy 5-on-3.
And that to me, is the difference in the hockey game. And when you get a couple of 5-on-3s, albeit one was really short, and you don't really create anything, Brendan, let alone not score. I mean, at the end of the day, we have an old expression. If you don't score on your 5-on-3, you're probably not going to win the hockey game. The Rangers had the same opportunity, mind you. But you've got to be more consistent on that power play. I mean, it was good, certainly, the other night in the New York Rangers, but way too often it's just not good. It doesn't get anything done. And at the end of the day, when you need a goal and the power play doesn't get it done for you, you're going to lose hockey games.
A minute and 24 seconds was the combined time in the 5-on-3 for the Islanders. They had a 9-second one early on, and then a one in the second period that was a little more lengthy that they couldn't capitalize on it. And in a one-goal game that was won by an ugly bounce at the end, that proved to be a big difference.
Well, we talked about that during the game, that the puck was really bouncing, particularly in the third period, and I think you made mention that, this is probably going to be an ugly goal, and I agree with you, and that's exactly what it was. It was a bouncing ball and found its way past Leonard, but I did think the Islanders had a pretty strong third period, and the goaltender Georgiev was strong. He had good position, I would say, because there was shots he didn't see, but it did hit him all except for that save on Lee late in the game. But the Islanders just didn't get enough done for me, particularly from an offensive standpoint. There was some flurries here and there, but they still haven't got that magic that they had on that last road trip when they were so good. So their takeaway is, again, continue to work on their power play. Certainly their penalty killing was very, very good, but a tough loss for the Islanders.
In what has become a strange trend for the Islanders this season, their winning percentage is better in games where they allow the first goal than it is in games they score the first goal. And that's the case here today again, as Anthony Beauvillier got the scoring started.
Yeah, it was a great play, and then that was right at the tail end of a power play. So you could say it was a power play goal, I guess, in some ways, but Josh Bailey's just going to get it down to Anthony Beauvillier, and he just makes a quick turn and gets it to his forehand and not challenged by the goaltender. I thought that maybe was the only mistake the goaltender made the entire game, as he didn't challenge Beauvillier. He didn't have anywhere to go, but credit Anthony with a great move. And then and Hedl on an Islander turnover, just like they did an unbelievable job killing penalties. They turned the puck over to make matters worse. Letty loses a stick, and Hedl, the young rookie, doesn't make any kind of mistakes. And Leonard, who has been so good for these Islanders, he had nothing he could do from there because he never established his position.
See the goal for Beauvillier, his 12th of the season, now 7 in 10 games against the New York Rangers, total of 13 points, and he finishes the four-game season series with 4 goals against the Rangers. He had a hat-trick back on November 15th that got his season really started offensively for the Islanders. Both those goals came in the second period and into the third. The game tied at 1. We talked about the ice. It wasn't a pretty third period. The puck was bouncing all over the place, and eventually it was a bouncing puck that found its way off a skate of Matt Zuccarello and into the net for the game winner.
Well, it's almost like whatever you had the opportunity, get it towards the net, because you just didn't know what was going to happen. And the Rangers finally, Matt Zuccarello, a face-off win by the Rangers, and they just fire it towards the net, and it's just a crazy hop. It bounced off a couple different people. As you watch the replay there, off of Zouk, off of Letty, off the goaltender, and then just has enough momentum to get itself in the net. But look at Zuccarello, he just drives right towards that net, and they just fire it there. And I talk about it all the time, Brendan. Shoot the puck from anywhere and everywhere, because you just don't know. You might get a good break, you might get a rebound, or you might get a goal.
Matt Zuccarello credited with the game-winning goal. It came with just 5:05 left in regulation. The Islanders trying to get back into that one. Took a bad penalty late. Valtteri Filppula took that penalty that really hampered the Islanders' comeback chances, as even pulling the goaltender very late just got him to 5-on-5.
You have to be a little smarter than him. Valtteri Filppula is a smart player, but he was reaching. That's an area we talked about, because the Rangers took a couple of those penalties where if you stop skating and you start to reach in, you're going to be in the penalty box, and you got to be aware of the clock, how much time is left. You're down a goal, and the Islanders have done that now twice in their last couple of games where they've taken penalties and taken themselves out of a really good opportunity to pull the goaltender and perhaps tie the game up. So I'm sure that will be an area that the coach will talk about and say, hey guys, we have to be smarter than that.
Islanders lose today to their rival New York Rangers, split the season series, 2 wins for each club. It was an afternoon game, which may benefit them because they turn right back around again tomorrow to take on the best team in the league, the Tampa Bay Lightning.
Well, that'll be a challenge for them, no doubt about it. This is a team that has all kinds of offensive weapons. They've got a great goaltender. They've got a very potent, very strong strong defense, and certainly they can put points up on the board. So there's no real weaknesses. They're the favorites to win the Stanley Cup right now, and so the Islanders will have to be on their best behavior. They're going to have to bring their A game, because I think anything less, Brendan, is not going to get the job done.
You mentioned the goaltender Louis Domingue is starting tonight in Buffalo, so we will most likely see Andrei Vasilevskiy tomorrow for the Tampa Bay Lightning.